Welcome back to Online Video Student, and this is the first of our Internet of Things specialty videos. Today we're going to be taking a look at the TP-Link Smart Wi-Fi LED Bulb. One of the best things about this bulb is that there's no hub required. You can control it from any iOS or Android device, or you can use Amazon Echo or Google Home to control it. This is the LB100 model of this bulb, and it'll put out about 600 lumens, and like most LED bulbs, it should last you for over 10 years. This particular bulb is also a very warm color. You can find information about that on the lighting facts on the side of most bulbs. And once you have it connected to your Wi-Fi network, you can access it from almost anywhere in the world using the application. One of the other great things about it is that it allows dimming. And through the application, you can track power usage and power savings over the lifetime of the bulb. Setup and configuration of the bulb is very easy. It's a standard size bulb, and it should fit into just about any lamp. Simply screw it in, turn it on, and wait. After a few seconds, you'll notice that it will blink 3 times. This lets you know that the bulb is online and ready to be configured. At this point, you're going to want to download the application. You can simply search for it as Casa or under TP-Link. Once you've installed the application, you're going to want to get into your Wi-Fi network settings, and you're going to be looking for TP-Link Smart Bulb. This is actually the bulb putting out a network so that you can connect to it to configure it. Once you've done that, you're going to want to open up the application. If you've never set up anything with TP-Link before, you're going to need to create an account. Simply click on Create an Account, but all they require is your email and a password. Once you've done that, they'll send you a confirmation email, and once you've confirmed it, you're ready to go ahead and configure your device. Simply add your device, click on Smart Bulb, and since we've already done this part and seen the bulb flash 3 times, and we've already added it to our Wi-Fi network, the application will connect to the device, and we're ready to name it. One thing to keep in mind about naming your bulbs and devices is that this is how you're going to see it in the application. And this is how you're going to reference it in both Amazon Echo and Google Home. Select an icon for it in the application, and then you're going to add it to your Wi-Fi network in your home. Once you've done this, it's a short wait, about 30 seconds, and the bulb is ready to go. And you can start configuring it and setting things up. This is how it'll show up in the application, where you can actually turn it on or off using the button, or once you click on it, you have a number of different options here. You can schedule, and this is where you can set it up to come on at a specific time, come off at a specific time, or to change its state. I'm going to set it up to come on in the evening at a specific time. And then I'm going to select the days that I'd like it to come on. Now you can set it to come on at the last on state, in other words, whatever it was, or you can customize the brightness that it comes on at. To customize, just simply click on it and choose your number, anywhere from 0 to 100%. Save. And it's set. You'll see it in the schedule, what it's set to do, whether it's set to come on or go off. In device settings, you can see things such as your time zone, location, the device time, so that you can check to see what time it's on, the model, firmware version, and other information about the bulb. Under usage, you'll be able to see how much energy the bulb's been using, how long it's been on, and your energy savings based on this bulb. It'll let you look at the last 7 days or even the last 30 days. To set this device up for Alexa, you're going to go into your device control settings and activate the remote control option. Then you're going to go into the Alexa application, and you're going to search for either Casa, K-A-S-A, or TP-Link. You'll see this skill, and you need to enable it. When you enable it, it will ask you to log in to your TP-Link account using the email and password you just created. And then once it connects, you can close the window that it's opened, and Alexa will search for devices on your network under your TP-Link account. Once it finds it, you're all done.
Alexa, turn the living room lamp on.
Okay.
Alexa, turn the living room lamp on 50%.
Okay.
Alexa, turn the living room lamp on 25%.
Okay.
And that's all there is to setting up the TP-Link Smart Wi-Fi LED bulb and setting it up to work with Amazon Echo. Setting up for Google Home is just as easy. Again, this is the model LB100, and I've included a link to it in the notes. Be sure and check it out and check out the other TP-Link Smart Wi-Fi bulbs. Thanks for joining us at Online Video Student, and we'll be back soon with more Internet of Things videos. Be sure and add a comment below and subscribe to our channel.